Hey, Don here. Well, I'm back working on the 76 Blazer again. And the last video, it was running. I was fixing to go test drive it, and it was running real bad. I had to move the light until I could get up in there. And change this too. So, there we go. Hook me a board on top of my battery so I could set on it without rotting my pants out. It's making a bad noise, running horrible. It seems like there's a valve problem, and I use my pry bar to listen around. See the other videos where I did that, and stick it to the round on different spots and then stick it to your ear and you can hear it really well. It's kind of like a stethoscope effect. And you do it with a long screwdriver or whatever you got that works good. I just didn't want to get with it running. I didn't want to get as close as the screwdriver, so I used that 2 foot long bar. Actually, it worked better than the screwdriver because it's just all solid steel. But anyway, I was wanting to put my light over this way, but to make it shine over here more, but the problem is, hey, that might work, as long as it doesn't, yeah, that don't seem like, as long as you don't shine your light at the sensor, and it's behind the phone, right behind it, right now, that gives me a little more light. I don't know if I want to take the valve, is it breather off or not. Yeah, that leaf's got in there. Maybe I should get the air blower out after or something. I should, because when I take this off, either air blower or the vacuum already. Vacuumed around in here before I started all this. These leaves wouldn't come out very good no matter what you do, huh? So yeah, when I take it off, I don't want all that dirt falling down in the head. I guess I'll get the air blower after it. Yeah. Let me do that. I'm sore.
Thank you.
engine still look the same. I would like to. Well, I've showed other videos where I try to figure ways to put a camera on my head. Of course, then it'd move around too much. But probably be more interesting in the long run than set cameras. But this is better than, I just like doing it. It's better than nothing. I mean, if you get a good shot, at least on the important stuff, then yeah, it's all right, I think. Let me get my ratchet and everything. Let's see. I don't remember what size those usually are. Probably 7/16. Not about it. No. Oops. Can't pick up stuff good with the gloves, but I don't know. I'll probably end up taking them off here in a little bit. We'll see. Is that a half inch? 7/16. I didn't have 7/16. So I had the right one in mind, but grabbed the wrong one. Okay. Where's my book? I don't even have a rag. Well, I got some paper towels in my pocket if I really need one. Pants will work for now. I had to do some more iron-on patches on my pants. Holes were spreading, and I used the last two I had. I woke up at 2 this morning, but I didn't get out till around 7:30. I'm here. Pretty loose, I figured it would be. Just get them all loose and then get them off. Need to get that off while it's still tight enough to hold it. I made it so I could put it on there and still get in to adjust my lifters years ago. And I'm gonna have to dig that out today. Cause I mean, if I'm gonna be in here, I might as well set my lifters anyway. So. That's what I'll do is magnetize my sockets. But it's usually a little grease is all you need to hold them in there anyway. Out, but I don't want to drop it down under the truck and have to go fishing it for it either. So, why don't we try using our hands? Oh, look. That one has a thing to help hold it. Flatten it out. Yeah, you know, I think those used to be used a lot. And I probably put that on there. I doubt that it was on those chrome valve covers when I got the truck. I still have a bunch of old Chevy parts. Boy, I need one of those rags. I'm going to use the bottom of my pants right now. I forgot to. There's so many, well, I'm not getting mosquito bit right now, but there's lots of ants. If I have to get down on the ground, they'll eat me alive, crawl in my pants. So I need to put that stuff on, at least before I do that. Usually I get reminded by the mosquitoes that I need something. I think it's getting drier as it gets hotter, and they're not coming out as late in the morning as they were staying out till about 10. And the last couple of days I haven't been having a lot of trouble with them. Well, I managed to drop that, even though that's my ground. Even though I knew that was probably there, that's what you get for talking and still working. Well, I'll get it in a little bit. Just long as I don't forget to get it before I put it all back together. I don't think there's any of those on the top. It's usually the bottom that leaks the most, but that'll spread out the pressure and keep them from leaking as much. But they used to have different sizes of those, and usually stock valve covers would have them, you know, top and bottom. And I didn't take the plugs out yet or anything, because I think it's a, I'm hoping it's something simple like a rocker arm just came loose. I haven't adjusted the valves. I don't think I've ever adjusted them since I had the motor rebuilt in 92. And I drove it a lot until about 2000. I drove it almost every day. Well, I drove it almost every day till about 96, 97 to work, like 60 to 70 miles every day, you know, full day of driving. And then I didn't drive it as much after that. When I did drive, I'd drive it pretty good a bit, you know. And then since 2000, I haven't driven it a lot. So, you know, that's why not a lot of miles really. So that's why I wouldn't necessarily. Oh, there are some of those little deals on there, the short ones. Just couldn't see them. See if I can get that off of there before it falls and I have to hunt it. Needles, I've got some right here. You know what? Me and the gloves aren't getting along at all today. You just can't do this kind of stuff with gloves on. Being silly. You can't work on a truck and not get your hands dirty. There we go. That's what I was talking about. One of those. I don't know if I showed the other one. That was some pretty good ones. That's about the longest ones I ever remember seeing. Pretty good. I ended up dropping it anyway. Oh, that should put me a seat on both sides. That sure helps. I hurt because I've been making myself sore, but the owls are not from what I'm necessarily landing on. Just because it hurts every time I move. Maybe I was landing on something. There you go. There was one there, and now it's gone. It disappeared. I think I'm going to have to hit the air blower after it again before I actually took it off. Well, I don't know. That'll blow it up in there. Fell up in the intake manifold. I just can't see. I guess I'll take my light and look for it in a second. Okay, where'd you go? Oh, now that hurt. Hit my head on me. Didn't just go into the world blue yonder. There it is. Way up there. Different place from where I would expect to see it. Yeah, it'll have to stay there. I can probably get to it better once the manifold is off anyway. see if I'm a bunch of crap in there that used to come out. Oh, there's a leaf in there. It looked like a black tape. It was rolled up in black, but it just had a greasy leaf. Wire loom, and has these factory dills on it still, and they have little dills they're supposed to poke into little holes, and there's no place to put them now. Maybe there used to be some brackets on the old originals that never had them since I've had the truck. It came with the chrome valve covers and the aluminum manifold. I don't even know what brand it is. Edelbrock and a Holley 600, it had a Holley 600 on it, and I bought a brand new one because it was in bad shape, the one that was on there when I got it. And I've rebuilt it once over the years, about 10 years ago, I guess. Maybe not quite that long. Anyway, valve cover. I think I can take it off now. I think I'll slip the gloves on, they'll help me grip that slick thing this time. Try not to put too much grease inside of them, wipe my hands a little bit. Yeah, these are a pair that I've used for greasy stuff, and these dang gloves anymore, they used to last for years, and now they last a week or two before they get holes in them. These were actually got only two holes in them. The other ones, newer ones, even worse, but they're not greasy yet, so. Yeah, I'll leave that on there. That intake manifold's a good, that air cleaner is a good place to lay things, and if you take it off, then for one thing, you get that big old piece of quarter inch sticking up to hit you in the eye, and the other thing is you don't have a place to lay anything. So let's see. Not sure. Yeah, I think down is better. Should be able to get it off without unplugging the plug in. Smells like oil and a little bit of fuel, so not too unusual, nothing unusual. Yes, we need to do a smell test on everything, always. Okay, put that somewhere where it won't hit the ground, or it won't end up hitting the dirt. Okay, now. Yeah, I want my screwdriver. Ow! Oh. Getting light again. I wish this hood would go up another foot. Damn it, that hurts. Let's see, are we recording?
Yep.
Sorry. Okay, now. Gotta get some more light. Oh, I was trying to get close so I could see, and then I realized I do need to get closer to see it better. Ones are loose enough I can spin the push rods. Nothing's off. It's hard to tell with, the ones that are tight, there's not any of them where they're under spring pressure that they're loose. And the ones that'll move, probably are about right. I believe now that I've got it off, I will adjust the valves. I'll have to go try to find my cover, because oil will go all over the headers and it will make the smokiest mess you've ever seen. Oh, the gasket stayed on the engine. I'll reuse it if I can. There's some grease that's trying to go down in there. Yeah, it's cork, looks like. One of the old cork gaskets. I don't even know if you can, I guess you can still get cork, I don't know. I know it's not, it stopped being very common back in, when I got the truck, about those times in 92. Sometimes you could ask for them, and sometimes they'd say, oh, we don't have those. Heaven for that, you know. But yeah, I see that other valve cover is all cut out where you can get to the bolts, but the oil won't squirt all over the plate, run down on your headers. Make a stinking mess and choke you to death. So definitely put that on there before. But I may have to start up for a minute just to see if I can tell what's going on here. Like if some of the valves are not opening or something. That's actually discouraging, because since none of these, I was thinking maybe one of these rocker arms had come off of a spot. I was hoping, really, compared to other things, it could be wrong. And I was thinking I'd like to show a close-up, but of course there's a jillions of rocker arm close-ups on the internet. But this is, an older. The motor's not a 76. I actually can't remember what year it is. The truck's a 76. There's another motor I had. What was this? Oh, it was in my 72. Let's see. I had in my 72 Chevy van 3/4 ton, I had a 4-bolt 350. Had it rebuilt by a discount place in Fort Worth, Forbes. And it destroyed itself. What did it do? No time at all. And so then I had to buy a used motor in the junkyard. That's this one. And put it in the van. And then when I got this truck, it was fouling a few plugs. It ran good, but it was fouling a few plugs. So I took that motor out. I was going to put it in the van and just put some valve guide seals in it. And I had this one rebuilt and put all the fancy parts on it and put it in the truck. It's a 2-bolt main, but it's been a good motor ever since 92. Never had any trouble whatsoever with the motor. But now I do. So. I'll go grab another camera and do a little close-up. I just like to do that. A little bit of close-up. Okay. While this one's just still running, I still can't tell where it's at. Light changed. Okay, you have to keep checking them. Sometimes they quit recording on you and you don't know it. Okay, go get that. And get a rag, a couple of rags. This pigtail's done for. I need my long magnet that I broke. I can probably drag that thing out from under the truck for me. Instead of having to crawl way up under there. Oh, maybe I can get it with a worm or something. Get it nice and dirty. over this way, thought I'd at least come back and say, hey, I'm trying to get this camera up and running. There we go. Hey, down here. Okay, let me get up here and look at my... Yeah, let me get up there and see where to get up there. Ow! Just what I do. I wanted to do a close-up on my... Rocker arms. Got my valve cover off. They're all in good place. Good place. No obvious problems. Yet I have that terrible noise. Now I'm worried that even though it sounded like it's coming from I haven't started yet, so I'm gonna have to start it and see if it's coming from the if I can get that to stay up in here or not. Maybe if I do it like that. There's a wire that just wants to hold it. Hold it. Ow. Now. Go around. There you go. I just kind of bumped it and went down. That's what I wanted it to do. Yeah, that's the whole thing. Now I'm going to start it and come and see if all the valves are look like they're opening and everything. Better get some cardboard and try to at least direct that away from the... headers. I'm gonna shut this one down because it's on battery while I go get the car going. Alright, you hear that? Cardboard. Okay. Make sure everything is out of the way where it can't fall down in there. Any wires or anything getting hung up in there. Yeah, that helps a lot, I think. That's. Now, let me get the other camera going and I'll start it up. Well, I'll start the other one when I get around here. Now, I'll do it now. Okay. It moved on me. I'm going to fix it. Camera move. So let me bring it back up, son. Absorber bands give. Okay, now you can't really see anything from there, so I guess I'll have to move it. Let's get it out of here. Let me just move it. Turn it off. Get my thing out of there. It's a mess. I think I just pulled out some goop. Yep, that's all I do. I thought I could see it. Now I don't even see it anymore. Be best to have it out of there to make sure it's not falling down in everything. I don't know if it's just running away from my big nose or what. Yeah, it is. That's what it is. Stood up and hid in the corner. Just did not want to come out of there. Okay. Now, anything else? There's a leaf that would probably end up going over. Okay. Yeah, let's drop all that goop down there. That next time I get under it, I'll get in it. Okay. Okay, let's see if we can try and start it up. I'm gonna put my stuff over here a little while. I'll leave it up here where I typically sit, and I'll sit in on it. Probably knock it off somewhere. Okay, now. You know, I threw away a bunch of my underwear rags, and now I'm thinking, I thought about washing them. I thought, I don't want to wash those. Reuse them. I used to wash my rags until they were done. I should have, because I just now realized I don't have any more of them. But I don't like to wash greasy stuff in the washer. Then you really got to run it again one or two more times just to get the grease back out of it. Especially those are too nasty. So I guess I'll have to give up a few rags. All right, let's go see if we can. Let's see if I can put that other camera somewhere. I'm either going to have to hold it or put it somewhere. I think it'd be better if I put it somewhere. I think I am going to have to hold it. So I'll just come and get it. Put it up here where I can get it, I guess. Where it will be gettable. Gettable. Gosh. Having more trouble keeping myself organized here. Now, let's aim it down there at the spot in question. Okay. Okay, I'll just do that. All right, now we'll go start it. See what's going on here. Double check. There's nothing in the way of anything. Plug board's about as good a place as it's gonna be. Okay. Left it with the lock. Yeah, looks like I can start it now. Try to find the horrible noise.
Doesn't even want it. It only wants to idle.
you can never do that way. I mean, you couldn't just open it wide open, but you could rev it up, and the minute you started it, that's why I killed it so many times. Don't warm it up too much, I'm probably gonna take the plugs out. Not too bad, a little bit of leakage, a little bit of smoke there. I forgot how to get my leg up here. Sometimes I can't move. I'm stiff. Okay, now. Let's get the light again. Get this camera. Going up and down, there wasn't no stuck valves or anything. That's what I was wondering, if you might have a stuck valve. I'll turn this camera off now. It's all I can really show with it. Want to get another close-up, I'll turn it back on. I think I turned it off. There we go. Yep, still running. Okay, so I know it's gonna be a little warmer now, so I don't wanna. Now those gloves got a hole in it with that finger I was gonna use. Okay, I just wanna see what the rocker arms feel like now that I ran it. See if any. I don't know if they, I didn't pay attention to which ones were moving, which ones weren't, but. I can't see what I'm doing. There, sorry about it. That light was just blinding me everywhere I put it. Nothing was, you know, it was a little squeaky, but nothing was grinding on anything. Not so sure that I even heard the noise from yesterday. Didn't rev it up, really. I just didn't want to have oil going everywhere, plus I figured it would die. I think I just need to try to start taking that plug now. I would leave that cardboard where it is, but that part's in the way. I guess I could cut it off or something. But I think I will leave it there. That one's in the way too much to leave it there. I'm kind of wanting to cover it back up with the valve cover. Make sure I'm getting a crack in there. I'd have to move that one, take that piece of cardboard out to do that. I think I'll leave them because as long as I'm careful, I mean, if I'm really worried about it, I could throw a rag over it. It's, I wonder if this one will go up in there further so that it won't. Water hose has already started running, huh? That won't be in the way so much. Oops. Yeah. Slow down the grip end and I can still get to my plugs. Headers are pretty warm. Gonna need gloves now. I thought about taking the plugs out before I did anything like that, but I really thought, well, it may not be of any benefit. And I still don't know if it's going to be, but that's the next thing I'm going to do to see if I can tell what's, how they're burning, you know. I mean, it could just be running really rough because it's got a foul plug, you know. But I think with that noise, it's a heck of a lot more of a problem than that. The little ladder is good, but it's also hard to, where's the other, oh there it is, it's a little far out, hard to reach, my tools, you know, that little tray, but I used to always put them down here, right under where the camera is, and I would knock them off, the tray off a lot, and especially since now that I got these wider, my other regular, like regular width tool tray I used to do that with, it stayed pretty good as long as you were careful. But now that these are wider, I've turned them over before. And that's yes, wider sockets going over here. So these are XL plug wires. They have actual wire in them, so they don't. They wouldn't be my first, you know, carbon plug wires, although they're carbon, remember that? They'll break down inside and stop working on you. I don't know if I got the right. Yeah, I got it. I had the ratchet going on somehow. That thing will switch on you. You can switch it 100 times, and then when you time you... That's one thing I don't like about them. They're too easy to switch. These, which of a camera I'm using. They're too easy to switch. And I'll switch on you. Too bad. I don't have my magnifying glass, but especially considering it's been sitting for 2 years, it's been started a few times. There's nothing in there, no oil, a little bit of beige-ish carbon on that side. I'll clean it out. I guess I'll have to go get my magnifying glass. So, I've been looking at a camera that you can plug into your mobile phone, and it's a snake camera, you know. It's on a little short fiber cable. It's about, I remember, 10 feet long maybe, 5 feet, 10 feet, but for about $20. Now I wish I had it right now. I could stick it in the cylinder and look. I mean, I'm not going to be able to see. I can look. I can stick my. I mean, if I can get my eye down that low, my head down that low.